I wanted to do a quick test just to show the temperatures in the trailer here in the summer. We've gone all through the month of July already, and there have been some days that got to about 100 degrees on the ambient temperature outside. And what I've been doing is running the air conditioner, which you can see behind me here is the mini split. And I've been running that during the day, and it's consuming some of the solar electricity, and then the rest of it is going to charging the Tesla. That's of course when we're not camping. I'm in here with my FLIR infrared imaging camera just to show the temperatures here inside on a hot day. Now in today's case, it is actually 93 degrees at this very moment, and that's 93 degrees Fahrenheit. And here on the inside, the mini split is set to 75 degrees Fahrenheit, and it's been on for a couple of hours, so it is down to about that temperature here inside. This is what the mini split looks like. So it's showing about 60 degrees on the air coming out, and the ceiling, as an example of this room, is at about 85 degrees. This is how loud the outdoor portion of the mini split is when it is cooling as much as it is right now. It's blown pretty good, but it's pretty quiet. You definitely can't hear it when you're in the trailer, but out here on the outside you can hear the fan blowing a little bit. The inside temperature, according to this Ericcel thermometer for the furnace, it is showing 76 degrees. And if I come over here to this other thermometer that I have that I keep track of the temperatures with, it's showing 75.4 degrees inside and 91.9 degrees outside. And that outside temperature is coming from this white line you can see right here. Here's what the probe looks like on the outside. The rest of the system that I want to show the temperatures of are here underneath this couch. And down here you can see the inverters. There's an inverter right here, and then the other inverter right here. This is the AC distribution panel, etc. So I'm going to switch over to infrared and show you what these temperatures look like. All right, so here is the couch, and it's the exact same shot as what you were just seeing. And so you can see that the red area here is where the heat is coming out from the inverters, and they're blowing air out from underneath the couch here. So I'm going to come down here, and you'll be able to see the major sources of heat here. So each of the multi-plus inverters are these hot spots on each side, which you can see right here and over here. And then up underneath the couch, up that way, there, that big hot thing, that is the solar charge controller. That is the main one. And then right over here next to it is the smaller solar charge controller. And it is negligibly hot. It's not even hardly showing any heat at all, actually. I guess it's over 100 degrees, but compared to the large charge controller, it's nowhere near as much. So it looks like it's getting up to about 128 degrees on the solar charge controller there. And then I'm going to go up and look around behind it, and I'll show you what it looks like up behind there. There we go. So there's some heating fins, or some cooling fins, that are, I guess, dissipation fins here on the back of it. And they're showing about the same temperature, 126 degrees Fahrenheit on it. If I reach my hand in here and put it on the back side of the charge controller, it is definitely hot. It's not too hot to keep my hand on it, but it's pretty close to the limit of what I'm willing to keep my hand on. This is the battery bank over here, and it's generally showing about 84, 85 degrees Fahrenheit, according to the FLIR camera here. We are currently sitting at about 3 p.m., and the solar has been charging at a little bit over 2 kilowatts for the last several hours. The AC and the car are both pulling energy right now, so they're pulling 2100 watts, and so the battery is being discharged at the moment. That right there, with the solar charge controller as hot as it is, it's been having about 2000 watts go through it right now. One point of clarification though is there are actually two charge controllers, like I mentioned, and so the larger one has 1500 watts going through it right now, and it probably had more like 1700 watts going through it for the bulk of the afternoon. And so it's hot right now because it's been charging for a long time, and about 128 degrees is about what it gets to when it has about 1700 watts going through it. The battery bank is currently at 31 degrees Celsius. I stopped the Tesla charging so that I could just show what the mini split is pulling right now.
and it's pulling about 400 watts. There's a little bit of standby loss from other things in the system, so about 400 is what the mini split is pulling. Now that is a variable amount. It goes up and down as it detects the temperature and, you know, compensates for it going up and down in how much energy it is pulling. And so outside it is 92 degrees and inside it is 75 degrees, and this is how much energy it is taking to maintain that temperature.
I thought I'd also show what it looks like here in the back of the trailer. This is the bunk beds. So this is getting the full brunt of the sun right now. If we look up here at the skylight, the flare camera is indicating just over 100 degrees. The back wall here is showing about 92 degrees. You can see that right along the corner there is where it's actually getting pretty hot. It's about 100 degrees there. The sleeping bag here that's on the bed, that is about 88 degrees. So if the girls were back here sleeping, it would be kind of on the warm side, and we'd probably want to jack up the AC in the front, or maybe have a fan back here or something to that effect. This lower bunk, this is the second bunk down, and this is 85 degrees, so it's a little bit cooler, by about 5 degrees cooler. And then this is the lowest bunk down here, and this is showing 82 degrees. So there's definitely a temperature differential going up the bunks, which makes sense. And then the back wall of this bottom bunk here is showing about 87 degrees. And it's especially hot right there along the edge of the door at about 100 degrees.
If the air conditioning wasn't on in the front of the trailer, it would be easily way over 100 degrees in here, as it was before I turned on the air conditioning and brought it down. So it's definitely warmer here in the back of the trailer than it is in the front, obviously, because the mini split is in the front. But that's the main living space, and by the time the kids are back here sleeping, it's nighttime and it would be cooler again anyway.
I hope this has been helpful, just showing you a quick little note of the temperatures in my trailer when it's hot outside and when it's under heavy solar load and inverting load, and how all those temperatures look and the energy consumption of the trailer with the AC system versus the electricity that the Tesla is pulling versus the production of the solar panels. I've been experimenting with this all summer, and I'll be creating another video where I'm kind of aggregating all of this information in a spreadsheet from the whole summer combined, and I'll be publishing that in a future video. So if you're interested in watching that, then feel free to subscribe to my channel and change that bell notification to all, and you'll get automatically notified when I upload that video in the future. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.